My village, Kfar Kadum, a Palestinian village located near Qalqilya, just 17 kilometers east of Nablus. The Israeli occupation has confiscated 600 dunams of Palestinian land for the nearby illegal Israeli settlement of Kedumim, which was established in 1975. Since the Second Intifada, the occupation has closed the main road for the village. Due to this closure, the distance between Kfar Kadum and Nablus has become 27 kilometers. This has created great suffering and economic hardship for the village's inhabitants.
انت بسلاحك ضعيف رغم سلاحك رغم اعتادك حشرة بس راح على ارادتنا لا يمكن ان تهزها لا فيك ولا في امثالك
Every Friday, I wake up and get ready. I prepare my equipment for shooting and carry my camera to the site of the protest. My camera is a companion that never leaves my side during the demonstration. At midday, while the older villagers go to pray, the youth of Kfar Kadum begin their protest against the Israeli occupation. Despite the overwhelming presence of the Israeli occupation forces, the youth bravely give voice to the demands of the people of the village. What distinguishes the demonstrations in Kfar Kadum from others that take place across the West Bank is the violent tactics the Israelis use to suppress the people. But as the violence of the soldiers increases against the people, the will and steadfastness of the people grow stronger. The leader of the Israeli occupation forces plans an ambush, preparing his troops for the violent suppression of the demonstration. At the same time, the demonstrators study the positions of the soldiers in order to ensure the safety of the people participating in the protest. I stand ready to film everything that transpires. I take up a position in the center, between the demonstrators and the soldiers. Many times, I get hurt. The soldiers always try to disrupt the protests by firing large volumes of tear gas. Usually, the ambush by the Israeli occupation forces fails. This failure causes them to become angry. When they get mad, they take out their fury on the houses of the villagers, randomly shooting tear gas and stun grenades in the direction of people's homes. Sometimes, they even take their anger out on the journalists by kicking them or sending them away, preventing them from shooting the suppression of the demonstration. In an attempt to separate the demonstrators, the soldiers violently attack them, forcing them to retreat. A group of soldiers then starts to set up an ambush. The people continue to retreat. The soldiers set up their ambush very well. The village youth resolutely stand their ground in the face of the soldiers, braving the tear gas and the stun grenades. The soldiers pretend to retreat. The youth feel empowered by their temporary victory. The youth then begin to move forward. Unbeknownst to them, however, another group of soldiers have taken up a hidden position close to where the youth are advancing, patiently waiting to trap them. As the demonstrators move forward, the soldiers emerge from their hiding place and attempt to catch them. Sometimes the ambush succeeds, while sometimes it doesn't.
على كل حدث الحديث.